Good morning. We will be studying today regarding the measurement in advertisement. Last class, we have discussed how we measured in digital marketing and internet marketing. So today, we will be studying the different method of advertising effectiveness and how it works. There will be a manager who will be responsible for advertising. Okay. So what is his responsibility? It's just not end. If you have executed any advertisement program and any sound managerial effort is finally interested in the goal attained, why the advertisement is prepared and why the advertisement is published and what was the reason behind it, that has to be attained. So therefore, always ready to evaluate the result, especially the advertisement manager. Evaluation of advertising or advertising effectiveness refers to the managerial exercise aimed to relating the advertising results to the established standard of performance and objectives so as to assess the real value of the advertising performance. So it's all about how much advertisement has given the effectiveness. Okay, and all refers to the managerial exercise. So what exactly the result we wanted to achieve, what objectives we have set, what goals we have set, whether those are achieved or not, by comparing with the established standards. So this evolution exercise is also known as advertising research, the performance, how it has achieved. So it is attempt to know whether the message designed properly has reached the greatest number of prospects and at least practical cost. That has to be evaluated. It is an attempt to measure whether the time, talent, and the treasure invested in the creative activity has resulted in attaining the goals of profit maximization to the advertiser and the satisfaction to the consumers at large. So obviously there is a huge creativity, time and thinking is spent whenever we are preparing for any advertisement. Okay. And whether that has resulted in achieving our goal or not. And the ultimate goal is profit maximization that comes from the increase in the sales. Okay. So sales, if you want to increase, the advertisement should be in such a way, the branding has to be done and everything has to be understood, and it has to be reached the large number of population. Now, what is to be measured in advertising? So it is quite obvious that in the area of ad effectiveness evaluation, the advertiser is to measure the ad effectiveness, how much effective that advertisement has become. That has to be evaluated. And however, it is not clear as to what is ad effectiveness. So ad effectiveness evaluation is a research activity, and by its very nature, it is to establish the cause and effect relation between the effort and the result. So how much, what is the advertisement is done and what is the effect has come out. So doing, understanding this, that is all comes with the if ad effectiveness or advertisement effectiveness. So the ad effectiveness is to be seen in five areas, namely markets, motives, messages, media, and overall the result. That has to be measured. So in each area, one is to look in for the advertising ability and the achievement in the light of the present objectives. That has to be checked. So advertising testing is indispensable because it enables to get down to the facts. So to decide on spending to guard against the mistaken notion that you have to keep on touch with latest trends which are going on to separate wheat from the chaff and the sheep from the goats and the winning ideas from the debts to multiply the results from the rupee investment so much. So every time advertisements agencies are finding new ways how to get achieve whatever goals and objectives we have set, and they are using the different methods also. So you have to come out with such a new methods which will make your advertisement better. So I've been telling you, nowadays it's very rare the people are watching the advertisement on television. So we have to shift to the digital market. And in digital market, again, we have seen what attracts most to the customers and how we have to design, how eyesight work. Okay, what people say when they search, what they look for, what they look into the content. So we have to come with a different thing. So nowadays, even if you want to go to YouTube, there also you find advertisement, the sponsorship advertisement. These all are coming up. We have seen it. So we have to come out of the box to reach the people. Now, when to test the advertisement? Testing of an ad effectiveness is possible at any stage of advertising process. Whenever you want, you can test it. But it can be done before the advertisement campaign begins or during its run or after the campaign is fully run. One is pre-test you can do before the advertisement, then current you can do, and then post-test you can do. So there is a pre-testing use the maximum safety as much is not lost. So concurrent testing makes him to lose little more as advertising process has advanced, that is going on. And post-testing result in maximum loss if it fails as the whole show is over and he gets the post-mortem report. So as to what has happened. The first pre-testing methods talks about, it's all about before doing any advertisement, we have to do some pre-testing work. Then in concurrent testing, we can do. But post-testing is all about when it is over and when it is completed. So that is comes under post-testing. So nothing is certain unless and until we are sure about the accuracy and the reliability of feedback that the advertiser gets from the such research. So that can be evaluated. Now, how to test it? So fortunately, advertising has a wide range of testing techniques or the methods of choose for evaluation purpose. So what methods or techniques he is going to use is dependent on when he is going to measure the ad effectiveness, whether pre-testing, concurrent testing, or post-testing. So pre-testing methods. So first comes is the checklist method. The checklist method, that is the first one. So here, it is the list of good qualities to be possessed by an effective advertisement. Okay, so we are using checklist over here for the characteristics. So the characteristics advertisement should have the honesty. Okay, and it should be honest in the sense it should do not fake promises and should not be out of the very, you know, can't achieve it. Attention getting, the advertisement should get the attention of the consumer. And next is the readability. So anybody can read it and understand it. And next is the reliability. So people should rely on the data which you are providing. And the advertisement should have the convincing ability. So they can come and purchase it, convincing them. Next is selling ability and the like. They should have the selling ability. The advertisement should sell the products whenever it is being published. And people should like it, or consumers should like it. And here the highest score is considered the best advertiser. Next is opinion test. So out of the people, we will make some group. So which group typically prospective consumers of the product or the services for an ad or part of it. So what we do here, the member of the jury rate the ads to their headlines, themes, illustrations, slogans by direct comparison. So the group will rate them. Okay, not everyone. The group will rate them and they give some opinions here. So getting preference from a jury is better than getting it from the member of general public or an ad expert, because the jury is the prospective consumer. So they will give the best suggestion out of it. The jury's preference is arrived at by seeking answers to the questions as to which ad was seen first. They will ask some particular questions. According to that, they will be answering to it. And which was most convincing ad and which was most interesting ad? They have created several ads and in that they have to select it. Okay. So which will be seen first, which is most convincing, which is more interesting, which is more likely, what do you like? And all these questions will be asked to the jury members. And next is dummy magazine and portfolio test. So dummy magazines are used to pretest the ads under condition of approximation resembling normal exposure. So dummy magazines means before any publishing, they just check it. So dummy magazine contains standard editorial material, control ads that have been already tested and the ads to be tested. Both it will be included in the dummy magazine. So the sample households receive these magazines and the interviewers are conducted to determine, recall the scores. They will distribute it to the certain sample members and from them, they will collect the data. The portfolio test is like that, the dummy magazine test, except that the test ads are placed in a folder that contains control ads, that where they are keeping it. So the respondents are given these folders, all the included of all the advertisement for the reading and the reaction. So the test score are determined in the interview. The ad with highest score is taken as the best and that will be published. So that is one is dummy magazine they are putting and another one is they are putting in a folder. And they will just check the reaction of the consumer and the sample which they are testing. And according to the which is get the highest rank, so that will be selected. Fourth is inquiry test. So here it involves running two or more ads on a limited scale to determine which is most effective in terms of maximum inquiry for the offers made. So here they go for several ads. So, and then they will check for which advertisements inquiries are coming more or the offers which have been made. So these inquiry tests are used exclusively to test copy appeals, copies, illustrations, and other components. So any of these elements may be checked. And the point that is to be checked is changed and all other components are unaltered to get the score. So these things will be checked in the particular inquiry test. Next is the mechanical test. So mechanical test are objective in nature, unlike the one already. They are explained. So these help in provide good measures as to how respondent are eyes and emotions reaching a given advertisements. So they are some mechanical devices used and then they will check the effectiveness of it. And what they check is eye movement camera, where you are looking for in the particular advertisement. Then perspectoscope, it is like the binocular method, which is used, psychogalvanometer and the tachyscope method. So these are the mechanical devices they use to test the advertisement effect, right? Totally on the basis of the eye movement, how the consumer reacts. So this is regarding today's class. If you have any